Yvette. So today I'm going to show you guys this really fun, wearable, radiant orchid look that I came up with. And you know, I know a lot of people are doing that really dark purple lip, but for some reason I wanted to do a darker eye with a fun pink lip. So I hope you guys like my tutorial on it. This is also a collaboration video with the beautiful Tara Michelle here on YouTube, also known as Warpaint. She does have a channel. She talks about like lots of product reviews. She does tutorials, everything. She's really informative. She's a great person. She's been with me since like almost the beginning. So please go to her channel, show her love and support. And yeah, I will link her channel and her video down below so you guys can just hit the down bar, click the link, and you're good to go. And I can't wait to see what she came up with, so I'm really, really excited. But yeah, thank you guys. Love you all. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe, and I'll see you guys really soon. Bye. Okay, to start things off, we are going to be using MAC's Painterly Paint Pot, applying this as my base, and I'm going to cover up any discolorations that I might have on my eyelids. Now, using any bronzer, this is actually the Jane bronzer in Inspire. You can also go in with MAC's Texture. As long as it's more of an orange shade, it's going to be perfect for your transition color. So I'm just going to apply this to my crease with my MAC 217. Then taking this color right here, which is Stars and Rockets by MAC. So I'm so happy that I started using this shade again because it's been a while. And it's perfect for spring because it's not too purple and it's not too pink. It's right in between and I love it. So I am using my Sigma E60 to apply this to my lids. Now don't worry if it's not perfect because we're going to be doing a lot of blending. And I'm just using a clean E25 for this. Now taking the color Sketch, which is also by MAC, with a 224 brush, which is also by MAC, I'm going to slowly apply this to my crease color because Sketch can be really, really pigmented and I don't want my outer V to be super dark. So we're gonna slowly blend it and then do some more blending and just keep going back until you feel like that color has perfectly transitioned. Okay, so time for eyeliner. I love, love, love this Physicians Formula 2-in-1 Eye Booster Pen. Seriously, it's amazing. It is a cheaper version of the Lorac front of the line eyeliner, which I love too. But this will last you just as long, and it's seriously amazing. But you guys know that I pretty much always do a wing liner, and especially for a dramatic dark eye, I always do a wing liner. I don't know, it's just a habit. But for my lashes, I'm going to apply some, let's see, I think these are the Ardell Wispies this time. And yeah, I love them. And I know I'm using white glue, trust me. I'm just trying to run out of the darn thing so I could buy a black one. But because I'm a perfectionist, I'm going to apply some more eyeliner to cover up any of the glue. Then for foundation, I'm using my Makeup Forever in the shade 125. This is the HD foundation, and I'm using my Sigma F80 Flat Top Kabuki to apply a pretty thin layer all over my face. And I'm just so excited because I finally got some color over the past weekend and I was able to use my darker shade. So yeah, I've been using this like all week just because I finally get to, and it's been a long time. Okay, so moving on to concealer, we are using MAC Pro Longwear Concealer in the shade NW20. And I'm going to apply this to my under eyes and make a funny little V shape. I did apply way too much, so let's not look at that. But using my Sigma Tapered Kabuki, which is the F86, I'm going to blend this out, and it's my favorite brush for concealer. Then I'm taking MAC's Emphasize, and I'm gonna highlight my under eye and kind of set my concealer with my favorite little Real Techniques brush. I seriously love this thing. Then using my Coty Airspun Loose Face Powder in the shade Translucent and a little, I don't know if it's like a velour puff, but it's a little puff that I picked up at Walgreens. It came in like a 2-pack. So I'm using that to set my foundation, and it's going to give a nice matte finish, but it's not going to give much color to the face, so I love that. But now taking my NYX Eyebrow Cake Powder in the color Taupe, and we're just going to kind of speed through the eyebrows because I know since this is a collab, new people might want to see how I do my eyebrows, but I'm just going to spare you a couple of seconds of your life and, you know, fast forward through this. But if you've seen me do my eyebrows, I'm sorry. But here you go again. Now we're just going to brush through them, and taking my Anastasia Clear Brow Gel, we're going to set them. So yeah, moving on to bronzer. Then going back with my Jane Inspire bronzer and the, what is this? Oh, it's my little Hoola brush. I seriously love this thing right now for contouring. I'm just obsessed with it. I grab for it every single day. But I'm just going to highlight my butt. I'm going to contour my cheeks, my temples, down the bridge of or the side of your nose, and your chin. And going back with a Sigma F30, I'm going to blend everything out. Then taking Dolly Mix Blush by MAC. This was an old school favorite of mine, so I busted it out again. And I'm using my Sigma F20 to blend out that blush. And I love it. And do you like the little hole in my hourglass diffused light powder? Don't even know how that happened. But going back with my little Real Techniques brush, we're just going to highlight the top of the cheeks, down the nose, Cupid's bow, all that stuff. And for lipstick, oh my gosh, I'm obsessed with this Kardashian Enjoy stick in Baby Doll pink or something like that. Milani lip gloss in Pink Lady, just obsessed. I cannot express my love for this. And I'm just going to set everything with my Urban Decay Chill, but I forgot to show you that. So for eyeliner, I'm using my Rimmel Scandalized Pencil in Nude, and I'm using that in my waterline, and I love it for spring. It just gives you that doe-eyed effect. Then using a little shader brush, this is one by MAC. I don't know the number because Smokey decided to chew on my brush, and he like ate it off. So I'm just going in with Stars and Rockets one more time, applying that to my lower lash line, then taking MAC Pigment in Vanilla. And I'm just going to highlight my brow bone as well as the inner corners of my eyes. I love this pigment. It goes with pretty much any color. Then Voluminous Carbon Black Mascara by L'Oreal. I always go back to this. This is my all-time favorite, I think. It gives you length. And it's perfect. It separates, it does everything you need to do. So yeah, definitely my go-to all the time. And I'm just gonna apply that to my lower and upper lashes. And then once again, we're just gonna blend everything out with a clean fluffy brush, and this completes the look. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. I really do love it. So thank you guys for watching. Love you all. Bye.